Let's now actually apply Newton's law of cooling. So just to remind ourselves, if capital T is the temperature of something in Celsius degrees and lowercase t is time in minutes, we can say that the rate of change of our temperature with respect to time is going to be proportional, and I'll write a negative k right over here. If we assumed our constant k is positive, then a negative k is going to be proportional to the difference between the temperature of our thing and the ambient temperature in the room. And once again, why did it have a negative there? Well, because if the temperature of our thing is larger than the temperature of the room, we would expect that we would be decreasing in temperature, that we would have a negative rate of change, that temperature should be decreasing with time. If, on the other hand, our temperature is lower than the ambient temperature of the room, then this thing is going to be negative, but we would want a positive rate of change of temperature. Things would be warming up, and so that's why a negative of a negative would give you the positive. So this right over here, this differential equation, we already saw it in the previous video on Newton's law of cooling, and we even saw a general solution to that. And the general solution that I care about, because we're now going to deal with the scenario where we're putting something warm in a, or we're going to put a warm bowl of oatmeal in a room temperature room. So given that, we're going to assume the case that we saw in the last video where our temperature is greater than or equal to the ambient temperature. And in that situation, our general solution boiled down to temperature as a function of time is equal to some constant times e to the negative kt plus our ambient temperature. Once again, we figured this out in the last video. Now let's actually apply it. So I said we were dealing with the scenario where our temperature is greater than or equal to the ambient temperature. So let's assume we're in a scenario. Let's assume a scenario where our ambient temperature is 20 degrees Celsius. And we assume that doesn't change, that the room is just large enough that even if something is warmer is put into it, that the ambient temperature does not change. And let's say that the thing that we put in it, our warm bowl of oatmeal, let's say it starts off, the moment we put in the room at time equals 0 is 80 degrees Celsius. And let's say we also know, just from previous tests, that after two minutes, it gets to 60 degrees Celsius. So we also know that T of 2 is 60 degrees Celsius. And given all of this information right over here, using Newton's law of cooling, and using all of this information we know about how bowls of oatmeal that started at this temperature have cooled in the past, we want to know how long will it take. How many minutes will have to pass when you put an 80-degree bowl of oatmeal in the room? How many minutes have to pass in order for it to get to 40 degrees using this model? So let me write that down. So how long will it take to cool to 40 degrees Celsius? And so I encourage you to pause the video now and try to figure it out. So I'm assuming you have paused the video and you have had your go at it. And the key is to use all of this information right over here to solve for the constants C and K. And then once you know that, you essentially have described your model, and then you can apply it to solve for the time that gets you to a temperature of 40 degrees Celsius. So let's do that. So the first thing we know is the ambient temperature is 20 degrees Celsius. So this right over here is 20 degrees. And so the most obvious thing to solve for or to apply is, well, what happens with T of 0? And what's neat about T of 0, when T equals 0, this exponent is 0, e to the 0 power is 1. And so T of 0 is essentially going to simplify to C plus 20 degrees. Let me actually write that down. So T of 0, which we already know is 80 degrees. We already know is 80 degrees Celsius. And I'm just going to write 80. We'll assume it's in degrees Celsius. That is going to be equal to, when t equals 0, this the e to the negative, or e to the 0 is just going to be 1. So it's going to be equal to C plus 20. And so if you want to solve for C, you just subtract 20 from both sides of this equation. And we are left with 80 minus 20 is 60 is equal to C. 60 is equal to C. So we were able to figure out C. So let's write what we know right now. So we know that T, let me do that in that magenta color. We know that T of T, that's confusing, uppercase T of lowercase t, temperature is a function of time, is going to be equal to, let me do that same color, 60e to the negative kt. Negative kt plus 20, plus our ambient temperature. Now we need to solve for k. And we could use this information right over here to solve for k. T of 2 is equal to 60 degrees. So if we make t is equal to 2, this thing is going to be 60 degrees. So let me write that down. So we could, let me write it over here so I have some space. So we have 60 is equal to 60 e to the negative kt. All this color switching takes time. E to the negative kt plus, oh, let me be careful, that's at time 2. So that's e to the negative k times 2. That's at time equals 2. Or I could write that e to the negative 2k. E to the negative 2k. And then, of course, we have our plus 20. And then we have our plus 20. And now we just have to solve for k. And once again, at any point, if you feel inspired to do so, I encourage you to try to solve it on your own. All right, so let's do this. So if we subtract 20 from both sides, we get 40 is equal to 60e to the negative 2k. Now divide both sides by 60. You are left with 2/3. 40 divided by 60 is 2/3. Is equal to e to the negative 2k. Negative 2k. All this color changing takes work. Let me know if y'all want me to keep changing. I enjoy changing colors. It just keeps it interesting on the screen. But anyway, so e to the negative 2k. Actually, let me scroll down a little bit so I have some more real estate to work with. And now I could take the natural log of both sides. And so I'll have the natural log of 2/3 is equal to the natural log of e to the negative 2k is just going to be negative 2k. That's the whole reason why I took the natural log of both sides. And then to solve for k, I divide both sides by negative 2. I get k is equal to negative 1/2 natural log of 2/3. I just swap sides. Natural log of 2/3. Let me do that since I kept the colors going so long. Let me keep it that way. Natural log of 2/3. And so we have solved for all of the constants. So now we can rewrite this thing right over here. We can rewrite it as, so we decided for a mini drum roll here. We're not completely done yet. We get T of T is equal to 60e to the negative k. Well, negative k, the negative and negative is going to be positive. It's going to be 1/2 natural log of 2/3. So 1/2 natural log of 2/3, negative k, so negative of a negative. So 1/2 natural log of 2/3, which actually will be a negative value. 2/3 is less than e, so you're going to have a natural log of it is going to be negative. So it makes you feel good that the temperature is going to be going down over time. And so times t plus 20. And so now all we have to do is we have to figure out what t gets us to a temperature of 40 degrees Celsius. So let's solve for that. So if we want this to be 40 is equal to, and actually now I'm just going to stick to one color as we march through this part. So 40 is going to be equal to 60e to the 1/2 natural log of 2/3 t power plus 20. Now let's see, we can subtract 20 from both sides. We get 20 is equal to 60e to all that crazy business, 1/2 natural log of 2/3 times t. Now we can divide both sides by 60, and we get 1/3, 20 divided by 60 is 1/3, is equal to e to the 1/2 natural log of 2/3 times t. Now, let's see, we could take the natural log of both sides. So we get the natural log of 1/3 is equal to 1/2 natural log of 2/3 times t. And then home stretch to solve for t, you just divide both sides by 1/2 natural log of 2/3. So we get t is equal to this, which is the natural log of 1/3 divided by 1/2 natural log of 2/3. Well, if you divide by 1/2, that's the same thing as multiplying by 2, and then you're going to divide by natural log of 2/3. 2/3. And let's see if this actually makes a sensical answer. So let me get a calculator out. I could just use Google here. So I had, actually I already forgot what it was. I have natural log of 1/3 over natural log of 2/3 and the whole thing times 2. So I can type 2 times the natural log of 1/3, natural log of 1/3 divided by the natural log of 2/3. Let's see what Google gets us. All right. How did I mess up? So this is equal to 2 times the natural log. Oh, okay, messed up the parentheses. Let me make this clear. The natural log of 1/3 divided by the natural log of 2/3. And then there you go. If we were to round to the nearest hundredth, it would be 5.42. So 5.42 minutes. Remember, everything we were doing were in minutes. So this right over here, this is approximately equal to 5.42 minutes. And we are done. That's how long it will take us to cool to 40 degrees.